a Department of Justice investigation.
That is what at least one city councilor says needs to be considered after the police department was again blasted at tonight's meeting about the number of deadly officer-involved shootings. Action 7 News reporter Todd Unger joins us live from City Hall. Todd?
Hey there, Doug and Shelley. You know, 2 weeks ago, we were standing and talking to you all from almost the exact same spot after a very similar meeting. A lot of victims' families coming forward and saying, we want more accountability from APD with all of these high-profile shootings. Tonight, it looks like at least one city councilor is on their side. After hearing another round at another meeting of families who say their loved ones were wrongfully killed by APD, Councilor Dan Lewis says it's time to at least raise the question.
A full review by the Department of Justice.
Translation, have the DOJ come in to take a look at APD policies and also cases where there are fatal shootings.
We've sat through hours and hours on Monday nights in these council meetings listening to testimony of families and listening to our department.
You're not opposed to it?
No, absolutely not.
Public safety head Darren White says he isn't entirely opposed to getting the DOJ input. In fact, he says the department has already reached out to some in the DOJ for ways to help them increase training to avoid those deadly scenes that have played out, admittedly, too frequently.
I'm very concerned about the number of shootings.
White says 18 shootings in as many months is too many. It's not exactly clear how a DOJ review would work, but Lewis says it's something that the council, and by extension, the city, need to consider. Now, somewhat ironically, tonight, three other council members proposed a resolution to mandate an outside group, a consultant of sorts, to come in and monitor APD training. Again, that would be an outside third-party group. A vote on that resolution will happen at the first August meeting. Councilors go on their July break after tonight. Live downtown, Todd Unger, KYT Action 7 News.